Hello, I'm Robin Whalley, welcome to Lenscraft. Today we're looking at the blend if controls in Photoshop. But as this is a common control shared by several photo editors, we'll also be looking at Affinity Photo. I'm starting in Photoshop with a colour image to use as an example. I'm now going to add an adjustment layer to convert the image to black and white. Because this is a layer, I can of course turn it off and on to hide or reveal the effect. If we use the blend if controls, we have much more control over how the effect of the layer blends with the layers below it. We can use it to determine which tones in the image have the black and white adjustment applied to them. You'll find the Photoshop blend if control in the layer style dialog. You can open this by double-clicking the layer in the Layers window to the right of the layer's name. Alternatively, you can select the blending option from the Special Effects icon at the bottom of the Layers window. In the Layer Style dialog, you'll see the Blend If options to the bottom center. Here we have two sets of controls. One relates to the layer in the Layers window that we have selected, and the other relates to the layers beneath it. In this example, we're only going to be using the blending controls for the top layer. Looking at this control, notice you've first got a graduated strip representing the image tones from black through to white. On the left and right of this strip are two adjustment levels. By default, the black level is set to a value of 0, and the white level is set to a value of 255. If I now drag the white level over to the mid-tone area of the strip, you'll see the colour returns to the image. Notice also that the value shown here for the white pointer has changed to 128. What's happening is that we're restricting the effect of the black and white layer to the image tones that have a value between this black point of 0 and the white point of 128. Where the image tones are darker or less than the 128 value, you see black and white. Where the image tones are lighter or more than 128, the adjustments are hidden, and that allows the colour from the lower layers to show through. In this example, we have a hard cutoff between showing black and white and showing colour, and that cutoff is a value of 128. This doesn't help blend the effect across the image. If we want to better blend the effect, we need to have a zone of transition between colour and black and white. Fortunately, we can create this by holding down the Alt key or an Option key on a Mac and clicking the level or pointer that you want to change. This causes the pointer to split into two. Now we have an effect where the black and white layer is visible between a value of 0 and a value of 100, where this left side of the pointer starts. Where the image tone is 128 or lighter, you can see completely the colour. But because we've split the value of the pointer between 100 and 128, the effect is faded between those, so you're seeing partially the black and white and partially the colour. And the nearer to 128 that you get, the more the colour shows through. We can also do the same with the black slider. Hold down Alt or Option, and then split the slider and drag it across. And now we would see the colour fading in between this area here. If we move the left side of the black pointer over, the colour would show straight through in areas that are darker than this. Now this example is just using a black and white adjustment layer to help you visualise what's going on. You can use this approach for any type of adjustment layer, and it's great for being able to blend together different effects when you want to target them on tones. It's basically a simple substitution for luminosity masking. Let's now look at Affinity Photo to see how those controls work. I'm now in Affinity Photo and I have the same image open. As before, I'm going to add a black and white adjustment layer. In Affinity Photo, we call the equivalent of Photoshop's Blend If control the Blending Range control. You can access the control using the small gear icon to the bottom right of the dialog. You'll also find the same gear icon at the top of the Layers Studio panel. As before, we have two sets of controls. One relates to the source layer, which in this example is the black and white layer. The other relates to the layers beneath it in the Layers window. In Affinity Photo, we don't use tonal range values like 0 for black and 255 for white. Instead, we use a percentage of brightness. A value of 0% would represent black and a value of 100% white. Looking at the control grid, there are points on the left and right side of the grid. The point on the right side is the white point. If you click this and read the numbers at the bottom, you can see the input value is 100% or white. That represents the tones we're targeting in the image. If you click the other point, this is the black point, you'll see that it has a value of 0% or black, and that's what you're controlling the blending for with that point. Now, where my points are vertical on the grid, the effect of that layer is being seen at 100%. That means you're seeing black and white. If I now take my white point and I drag it down, as I move it, you'll see the colour starting to return to the image. Now, once I'm at the bottom, what it's saying is that there is none of the black and white layer visible at that point. But at the black point up here, all you're seeing is the black and white layer adjustment. Notice how this creates a very smooth blend across the entire image, and much smoother than we had in the Photoshop. That's because we have this line that's now diagonal. The white point is at the bottom, or 0% showing the black and white layer. The black point's at 100% showing that we've got full view of that layer. But if you go to the midtones here, you're only showing 50%, so this creates an automatic blending across the entire image. If I now take the black point and drag this to the centre, you'll see the smooth blending reduces. What's happening is that the black and white layer is fully visible between 0 and 50% grey. Between 50% and 100%, what you're seeing is a gradual increase in the layer. So where you see these colours here, those are all in the lighter half of the histogram. Where you see just black and white, as in here, they're in the darker tones. If I now move the white point over to the centre, I'm going to create a very clear cutoff. So what we've got here is between black and a mid-tone grey, we're showing the black and white layer, whereas between mid-tone grey and white, we're showing the colour layer. Let's now reset this and I'll show you an even more powerful feature. Something that I think is great with the Affinity Photo blending range control is that we can add additional points onto these lines, and we're not just restricted to black and white. For example, I can add a mid-tone point by clicking it. And now I can drag that down. What you're now seeing is that the black and white layer is having a full effect at the black point and the white point, but the colour layer is showing through in the midtones. And because we've got these diagonal lines, what you're seeing is a blending between those tones. And you can add even further points to this. And really control how the blending works. Now, if you do this and you want to improve the smoothness of the blending, you can actually remove this linear option here. And what happens then is your line becomes a curve and everything becomes that much smoother in terms of the blending. And you can continue to add additional points or move those around in the image. The blending range control in Affinity Photo is an incredibly powerful way to target adjustments based on specific tonal ranges in an image. You'll also find similar tonal blending options in other editing packages, but they may not be quite as advanced as the Affinity one is. Once you understand how they work in one tool though, it becomes possible to translate that knowledge into other tools. I hope you found today's video useful. I'm Robin Whalley, you've been watching Lenscraft, I'll see you soon for another video.